AMG is the performance division of Mercedes-Benz. Those three letters refer to the founders of the company, Orthric and Melcher, and the birthplace of Orthric Rossopash.
Hang on. When you said pillarless coupe, I was thinking more along the lines of a Malibu or a Charger. I was even getting excited about the idea of an AMC Marlin.
This is the ultimate pillarless coupe. This is the one at Mercedes-Benz 500 SEC.
Thing is, it's got the lines. It just hasn't kind of got the muscle I was hoping for. It's more of a kind of an 80s dentist car.
Right, what I'm seeing is this. First and foremost, under the bonnet of this car lies that bad boy. There you go. That is your Mercedes-Benz V8 engine.
That is pretty cool.
Now, you need to cast your mind back to a time when there was these two young engineers worked for Mercedes-Benz. One of them was called Orthric and the other one was called Melcher. They were AMG.
Mm-hmm. But this isn't an AMG.
Not yet it isn't, but that's what we're going to do with it. We are going to turn this into an AMG car.
Okay.
What we're going to do is we're going to build the ultimate tribute car to those two geniuses at AMG. One of them was a misunderstood engineer. The other one was a bit more savvy and a bit more businesslike. He knew what he was doing. In fact, it sounds just like me and you. But anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to put the wide body wheel arches on it. We're going to put the AMG wheels. You're going to do the AMG stuff under the bonnet to the engine, you know, get your spanners in there and just make it happen.
Now, that I am more interested in, but let's face it, they didn't make very many AMGs and they made even fewer parts for them.
Don't worry about that, because the world of AMG and Mercedes-Benz is vast out there online. There's plenty of users, groups, clubs. There's plenty of enthusiasts. I'll find the parts.
OK, well, let's talk about the bit you have got, the car. I mean, how does she drive? What are we starting with?
Right, what we're starting with is a 500 SEC V8. Well, actually, it's more like a V7, because one of the cylinders dropped, the brakes don't work, the steering's a bit wonky. Should we get on with it? Come on.
Mike's managed to find some authentic AMG heads online. He says they're fine, which is why I've sent them here to some engine specialists called Motorworks. I'm Ed.
I'm Cisco. Nice to meet you. Welcome to Motorworks.
Thanks very much. Can we have a look at these heads we've got then?
Yes.
Cool. Okay, so this is one of our heads.
This is one of the cylinder heads. It's a partial AMG cylinder head.
Partial? That sounds worrying. Okay.
By partial, I mean a lot of the major work to make it an AMG cylinder head has already been done. As you can see, the porting has already been done. If you compare it to a stock cylinder head port, you can see how much material has been removed off of your cylinder head.
The hard work has been done on this so far.
Correct. So what needs to get done is we need to lighten the valve spring retainers, lighten the rocker arms, and you have to switch the camshaft to a more aggressive profile camshaft. And the intake valve diameter needs to be bigger.
So once we've changed the camshaft, lightened all the other little bits and pieces, put on bigger valves, and we're getting loads more airflow, and of course that's going to give us way more power.
Yes, it is.
So these are all the parts from our head. So this is the standard cam, or the cam we had in our head already, and this is the new one. Now, I mean, to look at straight away, you can't really tell much of a difference. It does say AMG on the end here, so clearly Mark, you know, Mike wasn't too far off the mark. But what essentially is better about this one?
This camshaft that we're going to be using has a more aggressive profile to it,
right?
Which is going to give you more lift and more duration on the valve. The other thing I was talking to you about was the spring retainer.
Mm-hmm.
This is the stock valve spring retainer versus the valve spring retainer that we've already lightened. You can see the difference.
Yeah, so there's like a radius on this one here, a bit of a shoulder on that side, and then also there's a lot of material removed from the top of that one as well. So what kind of weight saving do we make on this?
You're about 10.5 grams. difference between...
I mean, you can kind of feel the difference, but then, of course, there's obviously 8 of those, isn't there? So that's quite a saving there, isn't it? Wow.
The other part that we have is the rocker arm. And you can see the stock rocker arm has these big flaps on the side, which we've already removed on this one.
Okay, yeah, so there's a huge amount that's been machined off there. And also, it feels different on the back. So you've taken off...
Yes, we also smoothed the back part.
Okay.
The valve that we're going to be using is a stainless steel valve, which the head diameter, as you can see right here, it's a lot bigger than the stock valve.
So then you have all those parts that have been lightened, and of course that means that when they're moving around, they actually have less inertia because they're lighter, and of course that means you're going to actually get some energy saving, if you like. We're going to get more power going to the back wheels.
Yes, correct.
So you've still got to basically reassemble the head with all this new stuff, but of course you've still got to cut the valve seats, presumably, to make the valve actually fit.
Correct, yes.
In that case, I'm going to leave you to it, because you've got a ton of work to do. I don't want to get in your way. Thank you very much, sir. Cheers.
I've looked everywhere for the parts we need, and it's really not easy. After searching around the internet for what seems like days, I finally found all the parts I've been looking for. There's somebody on here boasting about all these AMG parts that he's got ready for a tribute car. It's the wheels, the wheel arch extender kits, the front splitter, the rear spoiler, the interior, absolutely everything I need. They're not for sale, though. Let's see if I can change his mind. Hello, is that Bob?
It is.
You've more or less got everything that I'm looking for. I'm interested in buying them if you want to sell them.
I appreciate it, but I wouldn't be interested in selling them at all. It's been too many years of accumulating the parts.
Have you got the car as well?
I don't have the car yet.
Why don't you just sell me the parts for the car and then buy the car off me?
It's really a dream car of mine, so I don't know if that would work for me. I'm sorry.
If you just give me a price, give me a number, chuck me out a number that'll make you want to sell these parts. Come on, give me a number.
15,000.
Done. $15,000, and this is the deal. I'll put them on the car, and when you come to see the car when it's finished, if you don't want to buy the whole car, I'll give you your $15,000 for the parts.
You got yourself a deal, huh?
Yeah.
That sounds great.
That is fantastic. What a relief. Listen, I was hoping to buy some parts today. I never thought I'd find a customer as well.
Thank you, Mike.
We bought our finished Mercedes AMG tribute to the racetrack, and it looks and drives fantastically. Hopefully, Bob loves it as much as we do.
Sounds good too, right?
Yeah, it does.
Huh? How cool was that? Well, that is the way I like to turn up to work. How are you?
Great.
Bob, good to see you. Ariana,
oh,
great to see you too. Well, what do you think?
Beyond my wildest expectations.
Seriously?
This is great.
That's a good start.
That's a really good start.
Great. I mean, the rims, the highly polished rims, that's awesome.
Go on, suck it all in.
Wow.
And don't forget, Bob, you're going to need these to take it for a test drive.
Right now?
Right now. Go and enjoy it. That's what it's there for.
All right.
Now, we need to sell this car. You've done a really complicated deal, so what's the story?
Well, you think it's complicated, but it's all up there in my brain, and it works like this. The car we bought cheap for just $2,500.
Yes, but then we spent a whole ton of money doing it up.
The money we put into it is $7,500, so the car owes us 10 grand.
Right, and then there are the parts that he gave us.
Well, Bob was being cheeky. He wants $15,000 for the price of these parts, and he was pushing it there with a price, but, you know, we wouldn't have got the car finished. So now the car owes us $25,000.
Right.
I can sell that car on the open market for well over $30,000. So this is the deal. I'm going to say to him, either I give him $15,000 in cash and he can walk away, or he gives us $16,000 and he keeps the car. That way, me and you, we get a $6,000 profit, which is around £4,000. Not bad, is it?
No, and it sounds ever so slightly simpler than I was imagining it was going to be.
Yes, well, I know it's complicated, but it's all up there. Now you just leave it to me, son, and I'll do my thing.
You feel like a kid in a candy store.
So then, guys, look at those faces, look at the smiles. So how do you think it's gone so far? Do you like the car?
It's beautiful. She's beautiful.
Do you like the way it drives?
It drives great.
So is this the car that you always intended to have?
Mike, this is the car I've been building in my mind for the last 20 years.
Really?
Yes.
Perfect. That's even better. Okay, well, look, it's a little bit complicated when we work out the deal because you've got $15,000 of your parts invested into that car. But I get it. It was a gamble for me and a gamble for you. For the parts that are invested in that car, I'll give you your $15,000 cash right now and you can walk away. Because I know I can sell this car quite easily on the open market. Or I'm going to give you a one-off deal right now. You can give me $16,000 and you can drive this car away.
How about another option? I drive away with this car for $15,500.
No, don't do that to me. No, this car is a steal. If I let you have this car for $16,000 bucks, he's done.
Done.
The boss has spoken.
The boss has spoken. Perfect. Thank you very much, Bob. You just bought yourself one hell of a car.
Click here to subscribe.